Ciao friends! In this video, I want to analyze with you the features of automatic daytime and automatic time intelligence in Power BI. As you are gonna see, there are pros and cons. Actually, there are more cons than pros, but let's go deeper and let's analyze what's happening there. Now, first of all, we need to understand what is this feature. Look at this model. I have a report here where I'm just slicing by year, quarter and month sales amount. The model is utterly simple. It only contains a sales table. We have sales, customers, and then another table, purchases. But let's focus only on sales. If we look at the content of sales, you will see that there are no information about dates in sales. Sales only contains the order date, quantity, net price, and a bunch of other columns. But there is no information about the year, the quarter, and the month. So how is it possible that I can do an analysis where I slice my report by year, quarter, and month? Actually, Power BI has a feature that automatically creates date table for us if we do not disable it and if there are no date table in the model. How does it work? It basically scans the entire model, searching for columns in the model that are of type date time, and it generates these tables for us. Then these tables are hidden. You cannot see them, you cannot interact with them. But they give you the feature of slicing in a simple way. There are some advantages and some disadvantages. Let's start with the advantages. Once you have a day table created by automatic day time, you can also create automatic time intelligence. So let's pretend that I want to see sales amount and I also want to create the year-to-date of sales amount. I don't know DAX enough to create a measure, but there is a quick measure. So what I can do is simply go to my measure, sales amount, right click, and create a new quick measure. When you create a new quick measure, you have a set of different options. I'm interested in the year to date. And for the date, I say I want the year to date based on the order date. Clicking OK is enough to let the engine create such a measure for me. Then I can take my sales amount year-to-date measure, put it in the report, and let's start from the beginning. It works. It is computing a year-to-date in an easy way. But if we go a bit deeper and we look at the content of this measure, you will see that there is a strange syntax. It's if is filter sales order date, then it calls a total YTD, sales amount, and this syntax sales order date dot date is kind of weird. We are not used to add a dot and then another column name at the end of column specification in DAX. This is an extension column. This is a syntax that Power BI only uses when you have tables created with auto date time. You can use it, but it's not a best practice because, as we are going to see, it's not a best practice that of letting Power BI creating these tables for you. So, the good of automatic day time is that it's automatic, you don't have to worry about it, and you have the capability of using time intelligence functions. With that said, there are also some drawbacks. The first one is that the Power BI engine will create one table per each date in the model. You have two date columns, there will be two date tables. 100 date columns, that means 100 date tables. This doesn't seem a big problem, but it means that each separate date table will be able to filter only one column. You might remember, in this model, we had multiple tables. We had sales and we also had purchases. What happens if I want to see in the same report the sales amount and the purchase amount? The problem I'm gonna face is that these values here in the rows, they only filter the sales order date. The filter will not go from these columns to the purchases table. Indeed, if I expand this a lot and from purchases, I take the purchase amount and I add it to my report, you see that it shows the grand total everywhere. Why that? Because the filter from the year will not reach the purchase amount. So having multiple dates which are not linked to the same date table is an issue. And the problem is not only if you have multiple tables. Also, if you have only one table containing sales, you might face a similar scenario. Let's pretend that I don't want to have purchase amount. I only have one table containing sales, but I have two dates. So I have in my model both this side, the order date and the delivery date. So I might want to produce the delivery amount and the order amount together on the same report. Again, if I just rely on automatic date time, I am not going to be able to succeed in this report because the date either filters the order date or the delivery date. So, what can you do if you want to solve those problems? Well, what you need to do is spend a bit more time and create an automatic date table, a date table not in an automatic way, but created by yourself. This is not a long process, it takes just a few minutes, but that's a topic for another video. Enjoy, Drawbacks!